DeShields, Jordan Reynolds, Schaquilla Nunn, and Jaime Nared will join us in just a moment.
Jordan, you gotta explain the ball. If you can pull the mic over to you, what's the ball doing here?
This is the game ball, and I will never let go of this ball until I graduate. And it may seem like a lot, but Dean told us that it was our first time beating them since like 2011 or something. And me and Donald were talking earlier, and they were like, this is an upset. I mean, yeah, because of our record and they're number 17, but I thought that we know what we're capable of. We had a couple tough losses earlier, but I think it just comes to show what we're capable of, and that's why I'm holding on to this.
Diamond, where did this offensive performance come from tonight? It just looked like a different team than Thursday night. What was the difference, do you think?
Well, one, like Jordan said, just tired of getting beat by Notre Dame and tired of getting beat in general. I mean, you know, tonight was a game that, you know, had we lost, a lot of people would have said we should have lost, maybe. But, you know, we can't go out and lose three games in a row. And I think that our team, you know, we're full of winners. And I think that our heart showed tonight. And we were willing to sacrifice and do what we needed to do for each other to get this win. It wasn't about any individual. Tonight we played team basketball, and I think that's where the offense came from. You know, there's no pressure on any one player. We kind of just found who was open, and, you know, those players delivered.
Diamond, you Notre Dame seemed to control the game early in the first quarter, and you had a really decisive spur where you scored 8 straight points. But could you kind of go over that play where you blocked a shot by 24 on the baseline, took it away, then let a fast break down court and ended up following with a rebound basket?
Well, I knew that Arike was, you know, well, we all knew that in order for them to win, she has to score. So I had the defensive assignment with Mimi out in foul trouble. I knew she liked to go left, so I sat on it. And, you know, I used my length, stayed straight up. She put the ball right in my arms. And at that point, I was just turning and going, just going to stay in attack mode. Our defensive pressure picked up in the second half, and that allowed us to come back and, you know, do some good things.
For Jaime, if you just talk about what was going through your mind in that last possession before you hit the shot there.
I knew the clock was running down, and Sadie set a great screen. And coming off of it, Jordan had been open off of it the whole night, so I knew they had to respect Mercedes' role into the basket, so I just knew I had to be ready to shoot it. Oh, yeah.
We all did. That's why we don't cry.
Quee, those up. You had a big back-to-back baskets in the fourth quarter. You had the O board, and then those were huge baskets. And Tennessee was going deep in its bench. And like Diamond said, this was a team win. Just talk about hitting those two shots and how key that was in this comeback.
I mean, you stay in the gym and you just work on certain things like that. I just did what my team needed me to do. I was told to go on and rebound because that's what I do. So I just did what the coaches asked of me and what my team asked of me.
For anyone, when you guys got the game within 2 for the first time, it seemed like both teams were kind of playing a little bit nervous, but you guys quickly composed yourselves. What does that say about your mental toughness?
Jaime, you take that so you can go on right.
I know we're a mentally tough team. I think the story of our season has been what Tennessee team will come out tonight. And I think tonight just showed that we're mentally tough despite our record. We needed to get this win, and we hunkered down and got stops when it counted. It wasn't the most perfect game. I know you guys saw that. But when it counted, we got stops, and we scored the ball. So I think that just is a testament to our team and the people on our team that we're tough and we compete.
Jaime, we'll let you go to radio with Steve.
Yes, Jaime. The shot.
Just for Diamond, what was the difference in the fourth? They were shot like well over 50% the first 3 quarters of the game, and then the fourth quarter they couldn't get a basket against y'all. What did y'all do differently defensively there down the stretch?
Well, like Jaime said, we hunkered down. I mean, the first half, we let them kind of do whatever they wanted to do, cut when they wanted to cut, throw alley-oops, shoot threes. You know, it was just like we wasn't dictating. Fourth quarter, that's what we had to do to win. They are capable of hitting shots if you let them shoot. They're capable of running their sets if you let them. So our whole game plan was to disrupt and get in the passing lanes and to deny. And when they did shoot the ball, we had to make sure we got the rebound. They were killing us on the old boards as well. So we just, it was kind of like a defining moment for our team. Like, are y'all going to play defense or not? If you're not, you're going to lose. And I was telling myself, and I told Jordan, I'm like, we can't lose three games in a row, period. Like, I don't care how we get it done, but it's going to get done. And, you know, defense ultimately was the name of the game there in the fourth quarter.
John Lewis.
Diamond, earlier you guys in the season had a big win over Stanford, got a winning streak going, then hit the skids. What can you take from that now with another big win? You've got confidence from this game. You know what you can do. Where do you think you can go from here?
I believe we can go somewhere we've never been. Regardless of what that looks like, I do think we can go there, and we can get there as a team. We can't look back. Stanford win was great. Kentucky, whatever other big win we had was great. But, you know, we have to move forward. And all our coaches, you know, it's no turning back now. We can't afford to do it. Our team sometimes, you know, we just fall back into this, like, slump. And it just, you don't know what we look like. Like, who are they? We can't afford to do that. So moving forward, just hopefully we can keep the momentum going and continue playing the way we did tonight.
Diamond, at the end of the game, you jumped up on the scorers table. It was making me think of, like, game 7, Kobe, when the Lakers beat Boston a few years back. What was it like when, you know, it hit 00 and you guys won? What was that team huddle like, you guys jumping around together?
That was just, I mean, speaking of places we've never been, I don't think any of us have beat a top 10 team since we've been in college. You know, that was a good feeling. So, you know, just want to show the fans that we're appreciative of them coming out night in, night out, supporting us. And, I mean, it was just like a jubilating feeling just to, when the clock hit 00, to be able to say, you know, we won and we did it as a team.
Wrap up with
Jordan and Kui, how much of a factor was the crowd, and how special is it to do this on the We Back Pat night?
You gotta go out play this before.
Well, I would say it's an amazing feeling. When we get up, when we do something well, you have your sixth person behind you, you have the crowd going crazy, and it flusters the other team a little, I would say. And this night, it was bigger than us, and that's what we were told before we even went out there. And it's Martin Luther King Jr. Day, so that was also another factor, but just knowing all these other things coming in, we just knew, like, this was gonna be bigger than us, and we were gonna have to go out there and do what we needed to do.
Ladies, thank you very much.
Thank you.